Rescued Art. We have a very special gallery on our website called the Kids Room. And it's hung with original and print art. Some of it's by kids, some of it's made by big people. It's appropriate for kids to look at. All of it is very lighthearted and bright colored. In fact, all of it's 10% off on our website now, rescuedart.net. And I wanted to read you a story today about how we rescued this piece. It's an original work called The Pink Ballerina, and how we saved it from being forgotten in a dusty place. This is the story. The Pink Ballerina. We pickers and rescuers are on a quest to save art from the land of neglect and forgotten. We operate under the unscrutinized mystical notion that we need to have a pure attitude and a magical intent to make good art come to life on the shelf in a thrift store. On this day, my magic was finely tuned to pink. This original painting of the Little Pink Ballerina by Dee Hawkins was immediately eye-catching. As I held it in my arms on the way to the checkout counter, three pickers stopped and gently touched the painting before saying, "Cute, cool. I wish I had seen that before you." Standing in line at the front of the thrift store gave me a good while to look at this pink ballerina and muse about Dee Hawkins. He was definitely a man, and he had no children. If Hawkins had been a woman, she would certainly have made the pink ballerina more a real, like a real child, one with fingers and toes and a nose. Hawkins had no children, because this pink ballerina could not possibly have been painted with child model posing before him. This ballerina is painted from memory, but not even the memory of a person. Rather, Hawkins had an image in his mind of a soft toy from his own childhood. He had not played with it much. The pink ballerina of this painting is clean and fresh and hopeful. Hawkins painted as a way to bring this soft, hopeful toy back to life in front of him. His talent as a painter allowed him to do so. The pink ballerina is beautiful and dancing so happy that her toeless foot and her fingerless hand are popping out beyond the border of the canvas. But why did Hawkins abandon this sweet, successful painting at this thrift store? He only painted it back in 2004, keeping it only 6 years on his studio wall. My sense is that Hawkins met Mrs. Hawkins in 2008, and in 2009 they had a child. A girl who wore brown instead of pink, who crawled to him with a prominent nose and 10 real digits. He didn't need a ballerina doll to come to life any longer. Okay, well, thank you for listening to my story. We're now just putting together a book of the first 30 rescued art stories. If you have any stories of rescued art, please send them to us at rescuedart.net. And we'll publish them on our website, and we may include them in the next book. The book that we're doing right now has two stories in it from submitted from guests. Okay, so remember what our beloved Valerie has said. All people deserve art.